Hello team, it's Arun Singh here. In our new video on abstract class versus interface after Java 8. Abstract. Abstract class is a restricted class that cannot be used to create objects. To access it, it must be inherited from another class. You cannot create an object of abstract class. Abstract method can only be used in an abstract class and it does not have a body. The body is provided by the subclass, that is the class which will inherit this class. Let's see the difference between abstract and interface in Java 8. Abstract class has variables, interface has only public final variables. Okay. Abstract class has both abstract methods and concrete methods. Okay. Interface have only abstract methods, default methods and static methods. And here we need to take a pause. Abstract class are the class which can have only abstract method but no concrete method, fine. But abstract class is a class which must have at least one abstract method. Okay. Interface, if initially I remember, it has public final variables and only abstract method. But these default methods and static methods are added from Java 8. Why they are added? What is the use case? We will see that in demo. Abstract class versus interface. Types of method. Interface can have only abstract methods. Abstract class can have abstract and non-abstract methods. From Java 8. It can have default and static methods also. Multiple implementation. An interface can extend another Java interface. An abstract class can extend another Java class and implement multiple Java interfaces. Very good. An interface can extend another Java interface. An abstract class can extend another Java class and implement multiple Java interfaces, which is already there. Final variables. Variables declared in a Java interface are by default final. An abstract class may contain non-final variables also. Types of variables. Abstract class can have final, non-final, static and non-static variables, while interface has only static and final variables. Implementation. Abstract class can provide the implementation of interface. Interface can't provide the implementation of abstract class. It is just a known point, but I'm just putting it back that interface can't provide the implementation of abstract class. Let's see a demo. Let us see in our IntelliJ ID. Here I have basically public class main, where I have public static void main. Here I have one engineering calculator and one calculator. Let us see first what this calculator is. Calculator is an abstract class. If it is an abstract class, definitely it would have some abstract method. Okay, we will see that. It has two variables which are private. It has a constructor for these two variables. And it has concrete method. Let me comment it. Concrete method add, and it has an abstract method sub. This has this abstract public int subtract method. If we comment this abstract, then also this class is not giving any compile time error. Now let me uncomment this back and let me remove this. Now this class will give an compile time error and it says class calculator must either be declared abstract or implement abstract method. Fine. Now let me give this class again back abstract this and let me comment this back. This class is an abstract class but it doesn't have any abstract method in it. That means it has all everything concrete. Let me go here and create an object of calculator here. it is giving me compile time error. Calculator is abstract, cannot be instantiated due to this abstract keyword. Now let me come back, control Z. Now let me come back and let me remove this abstract. Now this is the old case which we even have in Java 7. There is nothing new here. Now this calculator implements machine. Machine is an interface. It's simple interface machine which has public final string type calculation device, public final int precision 5, and public int multiply int a comma b and concrete. If I remove this public, any issue? No issue. Let me make it private. It's giving me some compile time error. Let me make it protected. It is again giving me some error. Let me make it default. It is again giving me some error. What is this? Modifier default is not allowed here. That means if I doesn't write anything, by default it take public. It's a good habit to keep public here. If I remove final from here, it is not giving me any error. By default it is taking it final. Can I make it static? Yes, you can make it static. So this is basically interface machine. This is getting implemented by calculator. And coming back to engineering calculator. Engineering calculator extends calculator. What is this engineering calculator? This is this engineering calculator F3, which is extending calculator. Let me remove first this constructor, control X. And this public class is giving me an error. There is no default constructor available. Why you need a default constructor? Because if you go to calculator, here we have two variables, and depending on two variables, we have a calculator constructor. To handle this constructor, we need a constructor in a interface also. Okay, which is doing nothing but just calling a parent class constructor. Now let me move this, control X, and it is again giving me compile time error. Calculator engineering calculator must either be declared abstract or implement abstract method. Very fine. Control Z. Let me remove this override. Control X. No, nothing happened. So override is just a marker annotation here. It's good to put this override here. Now, since engineering calculator is extending calculator and calculator is implementing machine and calculator is an abstract class, so there is no issue that you should implement multiply here only. There is no method of machine interface, which is MUL, which you can find in calculator. If you go see control O, there is no MUL method here. There is only subtract method and add method. Otherwise, get A, get B, set A, set B, that's much. So now it's the duty of a child class, which is extending calculator, to implement the method which is also present in the interface. That's why we have this override multiplication method here. Now coming back to main, I have calculator CC, engineering calculator. I have called the constructor here, and I am just system.println cc.addc and this. Let me run this for you. It should provide 7 plus 4 add 11, and 11 is here. Very fine. Now let me go and uncomment this part. Till now I haven't given anything that has come new in Java 8. Here also I'm not giving anything new. It is just a refreshment. Machine M, yes, machine is an interface which can handle engineering calculator. Now, let me go and check what all methods are present in mm. mm dot only multiply, no add, no subtract, because machine interface has only this method. This is a pull old Java only, nothing new here. So you will get only multiply. Now, if I do mm dot get, I'm not getting something like get A and get C as you are getting here, because this you are getting from calculator. So this is not a correct way of using of interfaces even in old Java. What mistake we have done? We have done this mistake that I have extend calculator and I have calculator which has implemented machine, but I have don't have put any signature for either add or subtract in interface while doing this. If this is not the requirement, then we are fine, because if you are basically putting instance of engine calculator in machine, you will get only those methods which are present in machine interface. You will not get A and get B. You need to pass this value by yourself. 6. Now let me run this. 6, 3, 18. So you will get 18 here. Fine. Now let me go further. And I already have this basically machine interface. Now let me do something here. Now let me do something like multiply divide. Default public divide int A comma B, and it should return double A divided by B. Any issue? What is the issue here? Public double, let me see the read element, which element? In null. Let me cross check this. A divided by B. Yes, we are fine here. Let me save this. Let me go back. This is my interface machine. I have this calculator class. There is no issue here. Even if you will go to my engineering calculator, even I am not getting any bug or error here. Let me go back to my main. Even I don't get any error here. Let me run this. And I am still getting my both the values, that is 11 and 18. 11 for this addition, 7 plus 4, 11, and multiply for this 7 and 4. So this is the catch here. I have made some changes into my constructor and I don't get any impact. And let me recall this point. In Java 8, we had made some changes, or Oracle has made some changes into the interfaces which were already defined from Java 1.1, 1.2, 1.3. Example is list map. This they have done for function to support functional programming, to support streams. So they go back to interface and they provided a mechanism by which you can go and update or add a method in an interface without impacting your present code. Let me come back here. Let me comment this. If they have done like this in a list method div, then if you will see my class, calculator class, my main, let control S, and let me run this. I am getting java.com practice. This is my engineering calculator is not abstract and does not override abstract method div. That is, my engineering calculator is having some compile time error. If they have Java 8 has go and modified their existing interfaces like this, then we all have to come back and to make the changes in our Java. So this is not a good approach. Even this can hamper marketing of Java, and might be Java can go out of the market. To solve this problem, they have bring a new concept of default here, like this. So this is the thing. Now even they have bring the concept of static, which I have said before, this they have introduced now. Now let me go back here, and instead of default, static division one, that is fine. So this, if let me give this code some name, let me give this division one, let me give this division something, what all I can do, modulus, let me give this method modulus, mod a mod b. Now it looks fine. So I have used default, I have used static methods, even I have used static variables in my interface, and there is no code change and no nothing I have to change here. Now I am getting something. Now if someone wants to go and use something, if someone goes and want to use something like mm dot divide 8, 2, then they can go and use it 4.0. Let me come back here, F out, and let me come for machine dot mode 6, 4. So I am able to handle my division method by instance and static method directly by machine interface, which is an excellent thing that they have done in interface. Now there is a let me go back and explain you by something by old problem that we have in Java. This is what I am talking about. This is a multiple inheritance problem, also known as a diamond problem, where you have two parents with same methods like add here. Now you have single child, where child is confused to take this add method from parent B or from parent C. This diamond problem is initially in C++, where you support multiple inheritance. Java doesn't have this problem because there we don't support multiple inheritance. We can extend only a single class at a time. You can implement multiple interfaces, but your interfaces have abstract methods, so that problem is not there. But after Java 8, your interface can have concrete methods in the form of defaults or static. Now, if that is the case, then this diamond problem occurs back in Java 8. So let's see in our second part of the video how we can solve this problem. Thanks.